Hey guys, and thanks for tuning in again. Today we'll be building a DIY Ambilight system for your PC. The whole system cost just 10 euros. For this build, I will be using an Arduino NANO, a small breadboard, a 5 volt 2.1 amp phone charger, and of course the WS2812B LED strips that can light up each individual LED light in a different color and brightness. I got all the necessary components from AliExpress and put a link to each one in the description. Let's get started building this thing. First things first, we need to measure the LED strips and see what arrangement is needed for our monitor. For my 27-inch monitor, I managed to fit 18 LEDs for the top and bottom and 10 on each side. The problem was that the monitor stand was in the way of making a complete circle. I solved this by moving two LEDs above the stand and wired them to the rest of the strip. When you're done measuring, cut the strips to size along the marked line that separates each individual LED. If you bought strips that already have leads soldered to the ends like I did, make sure you desolder all the wires first and put them aside. We will use them later on to connect the strips together. Next, you'll want to take a clean cloth and a multi-purpose cleaning fluid to give the back of your monitor a good wipe. This is to ensure that the strips can glue on and stay on. Before gluing them on, note the small arrow pointing to one side. Make sure when you install your strips, they all point in one direction and make a complete circle. The rotation doesn't matter, as all that can be adjusted in the software later on. Just peel off the protective cover and start laying down your strips one at a time. Now, before you start connecting them, make sure you thin the pads on each end of the strip. If you have a really small clearance between two pads, like I do here, just cut the wire down to size, put some heat shrink tubing on, and then solder the wire to make a connection. The rest of the connections shouldn't give you much trouble. When you're done, make sure you don't have any solder bridges between two pads. Check with the multimeter continuity tester if your connections make a full circle on the board and you don't have any short circuits. Next, you'll want to glue the breadboard to the back of the monitor as close as you can to the starting strip you are going to use. Here is how you should wire everything up. As you can see, the 5-volt rail goes directly from the power supply to the 5-volt rail on the strip. The ground connection has to connect to both the Arduino ground pin and the ground rail on the strip. This can be done using one rail on the breadboard. I'm using the D5 output pin on the Arduino to connect to the data rail on the strip. Now it's time to set up everything on your PC. Links are in the video description. Download the FastLED Arduino library and save it to your desktop. You will also need the prismatic unofficial software, which will control the LED strip. And finally, the Ambilight sketch that will be loaded to the Arduino. Extract the FastLED library and copy it to the libraries folder of your Arduino IDE. If you don't have the Arduino IDE installed yet, the link is also in the description and the installation is very straightforward. Just make sure you rename the FastLED master folder to just FastLED. Next, open the prismatic software installation and go through the installation process using all the default settings. Don't open it yet. Finally, extract the Ambilight library and open the sketch using the Arduino IDE. Here you have to edit the sketch to reflect your particular setup. For my setup, I'm using 56 LEDs and I'm using the number 5 data pin on the Arduino. Make note of the serial rate, because you will need it in the prismatic software later on. Now, connect your Arduino and make note of which COM port it is connected. In my case, it's COM7. Go to Tools and Upload. If all goes well, you should have the Ambilight library installed on your Arduino. Now, open up the prismatic software and make sure you select Turn Lights On. Next, go to Device menu and click on Run Configuration Wizard. Click Next to set up new device. Choose Ambilight. Enter the COM port your Arduino is connected to and select the serial rate you saw earlier. Also, for these particular LED strips, RGB works well, but if you have any trouble with colors showing up correctly, try experimenting with this value until you find the right setting. Save your settings to a new profile. Here, you're gonna customize the settings to reflect your particular setup. There are some presets built in, but you're probably going to have to use the custom settings to set everything up correctly. Enter the amount of LEDs you have. Enter their number on the top, sides, and bottom. Leave the thickness at 15%, and in my case, I don't have a gap where the stand is, so I put 0% stand width. Click on Custom to see what you ended up with. In my case, I had to invert the order and set an offset of 9 to get the order to start from the bottom right corner of the screen. When you're happy with the settings, click Next. Here, you can set up the color offset so that the color of the light matches the color of your wall. Experiment with these values until you see a white color being reflected from your wall. When you're satisfied with the results, you can tinker with some other settings in the software. I'll leave this up to you because you can customize almost everything to suit your particular taste. You can find helpful tips for almost each setting if you click on the blue question mark next to it. You'll probably find yourself coming back to the screen often in the beginning as you try out your setup with different videos or music. And that's it! Your DIY Ambilight system is complete. I hope this video helped someone build their own. The whole project was very fun for me, and I'm sure it will be for you as well. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. Good luck building your own, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers!